is working. Fine.
Yes.
So I have the privilege of 20 minutes for talking about lung ultrasound, which appears as a holistic discipline, a term that we will explain, of course, and we will see the example of the Blue Protocol for diagnosing hemodynamic pulmonary edema. So I'm glad to put a face on HK and the organizers. And this is a small travel virtual, a short lecture, but I hope it will make some comments. I have no conflict of interest and hopefully never, 35 years after a kind of a love story with ultrasound. I had rapidly 5 underground years from 1985, where I could, in 1989, work officially. I try to withdraw something that forget. I cannot see all my screen, but I will do without. So I could submit on July 4, 1991, the concept of whole body critical ultrasound, where the lung was only one part, but maybe the missing piece of the puzzle, the cherry on the cake. So I try to have my expertise in the whole body, but always honored for speaking about the lung. So let's be short. In lung ultrasound in the critically ill, that is LUCI for making short, we have 7 principles. I remind the first one, a simple equipment is the best. We will come back to this. We will remind for the beginners, but also for the experts, the basis of LUCI, that is the 10 basic signs. So I know I speak mostly to cardiologists, so we will be focused on what is interesting for them. This is the pleural line, that is a short axis of the ribs showing the parietal pleura, which is the pleural line here, making with the shadow and the superficie of the ribs, sorry, the bat sign, the bat sign, indicating we have the parietal pleura for sure. The A line is a repetition of the pleural line, which indicates that below the pleural line, we have aeric structures. Alive or dead, we still don't know on this image. The lung sliding is the third sign, very basic. That is, in this rectangle that we call the Merlin space, we can see a sparkling that begins exactly from the pleural line. You can see only the pleural line or the hole of the Merlin space to see that the air which is below the parietal pleura is alveolar air, which means there is no pneumothorax on just this image. Lung sliding can be seen on real time and also on M mode, showing this sandy pattern below the pleural line with a kind of a stratospheric pattern above. That is the seashore sign. We don't need Doppler for having the certitude that we have a correct lung sliding. We go rapidly on the pleural effusion, which shows the quad sign mainly. That is, we see one line which is bright, which is not the pleural line, but the lung line, which is parallel to the pleural line and moves toward the pleural line on inspiration, making the sinusoid sign. No need for Doppler. We go rapidly. The lung consolidation. We use the fractal philosophy. This consolidation is subpleural, so we can see it. And we can see what we call the fractal sign or the shred sign, which clearly indicates lung consolidation. Here, partial. Here is a huge translobar consolidation. It is also subpleural, which means that the word subpleural for the experts is useless. And we see the lung sign, we called this sign like this because a novice has the feeling to see a whole lung anatomical, but that is completely abnormal. The lung should not be seen with ultrasound. Fully specific also, no need for Doppler. The B line will be of interest for the cardiologist. The B line is an artifact, that does not mean a parasite, with 7 criteria. It will indicate interstitial syndrome, but first we need to define the B line, which is always a comet tail artifact, which always arises from the pleural line, which always moves with lung sliding at the condition that lung sliding is present. We can see it moving. There are 4 other criteria that are almost always present. With the word almost, you make a universal definition. Almost always, it is long, spreading without fading. Almost always, well-defined, like a laser. Almost always, it erases the A lines that should be located at these areas. Almost always, it is hyperechoic, that is white like the pleural line. More than 2 B lines between 2 ribs, that is in a 25 millimeter view, are called lung rockets. Lung rockets indicate interstitial syndrome with full accuracy. The pneumothorax is first this image that I showed to you without comment. So here again, there is no need for Doppler. So a simple machine can do the work. Now we see what is the A prime profile of the Blue Protocol. We can see a complete abolition at the left image of lung sliding anteriorly, which makes in the M mode the stratosphere sign. It looks like stratospheric phenomena. And now I look carefully in the Merlin space and I see only A lines, one A line here. We have the A prime profile defined this way. The A line is already in the scale. Fully sensitive, not specific. For being specific, we need to have the lung point. The lung point is the very point where an A prime profile, it could be an A prime profile if the video was activated, when the A prime profile is suddenly replaced by any other profile. So I put the video and we can see that in a respiratory rhythm, something comes from the right on, off, suddenly. This something is a bit of lung sliding, a bit of B lines. This is the lung point. We know that this is a pneumothorax. The location of the lung point indicates the volume of the pneumothorax. And once again, Doppler is not necessary. Now we can take a look, it will be short, of the Blue Protocol. The Blue Protocol is a fast protocol. 3 minutes, sometimes 5 seconds are necessary for knowing what is the cause of a respiratory failure. It considers the lung, that's logical, that's the suffering organ. It considers the vein each time the patient has a normal anterior profile because pulmonary embolism is here suspected. It considers the heart just to say that the Blue Protocol can deeply simplify the expert echocardiography to the point in this protocol, not to be included. In this slide, we don't see any cardiac item. We see only lung and venous items. We see the six main causes of respiratory failure. And so pulmonary edema, that is hemodynamic, pulmonary embolism, pneumonia, COPD asthma that we put together, that's the same kind of disease, and pneumothorax. In this short lecture, we will give a very few examples, that is hemodynamic edema, pneumonia. The B profile is lung sliding present at the four anterior points that we will see a bit later, associated with lung sliding. And we are obliged to add, I don't see any anterior consolidation. This is the B profile. It is 97% sensitive, 95% specific to hemodynamic pulmonary edema. I can see here more than two for sure, maybe four, maybe five B lines moving at the four anterior points. In this slide, we can see the second basic example, which is the C profile, where I can see not only B lines, but also a subpleural, of course, small lung consolidation. It is anterior. This is the C profile, which is 98% specific to pneumonia. And ARDS, time is running very fast. We have to remind again the B profile, which is maybe for the beginners, the most important part of the blue protocol. So we say it differently. This is a B line with the seven criteria. These are lung rockets, several B lines. These several B lines are disseminated harmoniously to the whole anterior wall. I do not see any consolidation. And the lung sliding is present. This is the B profile. And now, and only now, we can say sensitivity 97, specificity 95 for acute hemodynamic pulmonary edema. Now, let us see carefully. We are at the anterior wall, one probe which is universal for the whole body, a simple equipment, no Doppler, Doppler not used. We are at the anterior wall, left and right, we see lung rockets. To the left, there is a lung sliding. To the right, there is no lung sliding. It is abolished. Very basically, we can say, to the left, this is the B profile of likely a hemodynamic edema. And to the right, this is what we called the B prime profile, which is almost always pneumonia and or ARDS, which is the same to simplify. If we see lung rockets with, I can see here, a trace lung consolidation, what some colleagues call irregular second pleural line, we call it lung consolidations, that is anteriorly the C profile, we can say, this is not a hemodynamic edema. This is usually pneumonia ARDS. We are very late. So we can see that just looking by lung sliding, which is present or abolished with several B lines, we can say B profile or B prime profile, two different diagnoses, two different therapies. People ask, why is the heart not included in the decision tree? And we quietly give a scientific reason. There is a political one, but scientifically, the heart does not feature because we look at the suffering organ, which is the lung. But of course, once we have the probe in our hands, we scan the heart. Of course, like any doctor would do, it is associated that is not included, it's not the same. Said differently, I see this profile in a dyspneic patient. I can say very fast that the left ventricle systolic and diastolic function, as well as the coaptation of the left valves, work because I don't see any sign of pulmonary edema. The dyspnea does not come from a left heart disease. So I need to warn that lung ultrasound is easy, but not completely easy. And we just need to master many points. Each point is very simple, but the number makes the science a bit subtle. So we will go rapidly. We try to avoid to complicate this science by cleaning any points which are wrong, illogical, confusing, complicated, inesthetical. That is a wiki acronym in a commentary that you can read for free in internet. For example, most experts, when they make lung ultrasound, cite the zone 2 and 4 of a consensus paper published some years ago. If you put the probe on zone 2 or 4, you will see the liver, which is not good. But worse, you can confuse it with a lung consolidation and make the wrong diagnosis of pneumonia to somebody who just has a liver. So this is why we have designed the blue points, which are done according to the two hands applied on the anterior wall. And we have 3 points, one coming from the second. Time is running, so I have to go rapidly. Upper blue point, lower blue point, and flaps point posteriorly. Beware non-adapted equipment. The simplest machines are the best. The very modern machines have facilities that are filters, harmonics, and plenty of devices, of sophistications, which can destroy the lung ultrasound, which is a subtle art. The probe, this is the one we use, by the way. And we use the philosophy of one probe, universal for the whole body. This is a modern machine now, where I can see clearly a very diseased lung. But if I want to see the heart with the same probe, I have a clear vision of here the pericardial and left ventricle status. That is simple echocardiography. And if I want to see the veins, I can see clearly a complete thrombosis of the jugular vein. Look the upstairs images that are taken from a cardiac probe and downstairs from our 1992 technology. So it is possible to make diagnosis. It is more difficult, and sometimes it will be more confusing. One example of misconception, they all say obesity is a hindrance in lung ultrasound. So look at this patient, very bariatric, but in spite of the high thickness of fat, I can see clearly there is no B-line, no pulmonary edema, and there is the C-shore sign, no pneumothorax, because this patient has the A profile, that is the normal profile. So I will go rapidly on the false protocol, which is devoted to acute circulatory failure, where we rule out obstructive shock by putting lung ultrasound for pneumothorax. And then we rule out cardiogenic shock by ruling out the B profile of the blue protocol. It's very schematic. And then when we have the A profile, we are enabled to have clearance for giving fluid therapy. I go too rapidly for not missing the end. This is the decision tree. The SESAMI protocol, it's too late. It's a very fast protocol for non-shockable causes of cardiac arrest, and we begin by the lung, pneumothorax, then pulmonary embolism by looking at the veins, hypovolemic arrest in the abdominal, then the pericardium, and last, we see the very heart, with usually poor prognosis. I will skip this slide, just showing that a very simple machine can make better than the machines of today. Each time we want to know the function of the lung, we can make lung ultrasound, which is a very translational discipline. Take home message in the last seconds. This patient has the B profile, that is B lines, multiple lung rockets, anterior symmetrical without any consolidation. With lung sliding, such a patient has likely hemodynamic pulmonary edema or very few rare differential diagnoses, some pneumonia, some chronic interstitial disease. We have the pleasure to finish on time, and maybe
sorry, if the audience... Sorry to make you feel rushed. Thank